everyone, and welcome back to my channel. I'm here today to film another Christmas planner setup for you. And again, this is one that I already set up off camera, and I'm just going to walk through it with you today, and I hope that you're okay with that. My time has just been a little bit limited, and so I've had to make the most of it, but I figure that's okay and that you guys won't mind. So let's go ahead and go into this. This is a Recollections planner from Michaels in black, and I've had this for probably a little over a year now, and I really do love this planner. I don't use it very often because I don't always use dark colors, but it just seemed appropriate for this setup. And this here is a Christmas setup using the digital Christmas papers from the Planner Society, Christmas papers and Christmas art. Now, please forgive the sound in the background. My cat just decided that he needed a snack, so he's chowing down right now, and I'm sorry. But let's go ahead and get into this. Let's start with the dividers themselves, just like I did in the last planner. Now, these again are digital papers that I purchased from the Planner Society, or from Christy Tomlinson, as she is on Etsy, and it was her Christmas set. And this top acetate here, this is, there's something on here. This is the Gold Bow acetate from, I want to say, September's kit, but I don't remember. So this was not part of the kit, but she did have other bow papers that you could print on, you know, acetate. So if you wanted to make your own, but I just cut this to cover it. And all I did was use the floral paper. Again, I only printed it single-sided because it's for my planner. So to save ink, I just did single-sided. And then I used some labels from one of the previous Planner Society kits. This top one here, I used the floral and then the acetate on top of it. Then I used the black plaid, and then I used the black and green plaid. Okay. And I printed this, so I opened up the clip art in the silhouette, and I traced it and cut out some die cuts. So this is just a black plaid bow, like a gingham bow. And then these here are clips from previous Planner Society kits. I don't believe they're from the same one, but they're from previous kits, and I just felt like the colors matched perfectly. I do still have my today marker back there, which I need to move because it is now Monday, so we're here, but I'm still using it. It doesn't match entirely, but I didn't feel like making a new one. And then in the back here, I just have my little pocket again. And then here on the side, I have another one of her pieces of art as a die cut. And then I have this little pony clip, which is from her previous Planner Society kit. And then I have this polka dot pen, crystal pen, which is also from her previous Planner Society kit. So I can tell that you can continue to put those to use. Excuse me. And then that's all I have on this side. Pretty simple, but I felt like it looked really pretty. Obviously, this front section is my weekly section, then my calendar, then my notes section. And then let's talk about the pockets. So here I have a bunch of the artwork that I made into die cuts from Christy's digital artwork. So let me just show you what I've got. I have a sweater, some holly, this sweet girl here with her boots, and then there's some mugs, another piece of holly, some florals. This is a hat, and then another piece of floral. And then this foiled die cut here is from a Project Life box that you can get at Michaels. And then I have this K&Co XO bow that I just put right here on top because I felt like it was pretty and festive. And then I have these two clips here. I don't remember who they're from. I've got a Rudolph, like a sweet little reindeer, and then I also have a gingerbread girl, and I don't remember who those are from, but I will look and try to link it down below. And then here I have this Happy Holidays sticker. This is a sticker from Michaels. It came in a 4-pack, and I just thought it was really sweet, and so I put that here on the front. I have this front die cut held on by this little tiny bow clip that I got from Nikki from the planner. I'm sorry, from Nikki Plus 3. And then this little sweet green bow, which is also from the Planner Society. So there's lots of Planner Society going on in this planner. But I hope that makes you feel better about, you know, using your kits again, because these are things, you know, from previous Planner Society kits that obviously I pulled in here. So, and then here in the pocket, I have a gold die cut from Michaels. And then I created a washi sampler sheet. This, I just put 3 on here. This is a Simply Gilded washi. This is from Silent Poetry Arts, and this is from Scotch, and this is just a piece of paper from a previous Planner Society kit, so I just stuck that back there for some color. And this is actually an ornament, one of the ornaments that I have on my tree that I got at Target, and I just put it back there for some color and some sparkle. And literally, you guys, that is it. This planner took me maybe 15 minutes to put together. The longest part was picking the papers and printing them and then making the die cuts, but even that wasn't that hard. If you're curious on how to make die cuts using Christie's digital artwork, you can find the Planner Society group on Facebook, and she has some tutorials on there. So it's actually really, really simple. And if you don't have a, you know, cutting tool, these are sized really nicely in the digital artwork that you purchase, and you can just print it on cardstock and cut it by hand. It's no big deal. I mean, obviously that's going to be harder, but it's completely doable. So don't feel like if you don't have a Planner Society kit that you can't use these. I mean, you don't have a Silhouette, you can't use these items, because you can, or a cutting machine. You can use a Cricut too. But that is it for this planner setup, you guys. This one is going to bring me into Christmas Eve week as well as Christmas. I just like something a little bit more traditional for actual Christmas. This is very much what my house looks like. I have, if I had some acorns in here, then that would be, I'm not acorns, pine cones. That would be my house to a T, but yeah, if you liked this video, I know it's really short and I'm sorry, but if you liked this video, go ahead and give me a thumbs up. If you want to see more videos like this, make sure you subscribe and stay tuned for more planner setups. I've got another Planner Society setup coming probably Friday, and I will see you guys in the next video. Hope you're having a great day. Take care. Bye.